I'm Elisa with Scripts and Scribes, and we are at the 2014 Screenwriters World Conference. That is a mouthful. And we are with Ted Sullivan, who is a writer for the show Revenge. Some of you may have heard of it. Thank you so much for talking with us.
Thanks for having me.
And so when I was watching the panel, you were talking about kind of how long the days can be in the writer's room. So what, give us a little bit of an idea of like what your day is like.
All right, so we usually get in pretty early. So sometime, this season's a little bit later than last season. Last season we were getting in like 8 o'clock in the morning. You start your day in your office. You start your day kind of putting your ideas together, what your pitches are gonna be in the room. If you're working on an episode, maybe working on that a little bit. Then we get into the room probably about 9:30, and whoever's driving the bus, whoever's episode it is theirs, are at the board. We sit around a table, and it's basically like a classroom. It's basically like a graduate school classroom where you're throwing out ideas, and some of them land, some of them don't. The person who's episode it is kind of spearheads the whole process, and we're in that room. I mean, we just do not leave that room. We eat lunch in the room. They can be long days, and then you go home and you keep working, you know. My day usually ends around midnight, and then start over again the next day. But it's, each room is different. When I was at Law and Order Criminal Intent, it was 10 in the morning to 4 in the afternoon.
Well, what happened? Why did...
Right. No, it was... That job spoiled me.
What are you doing to yourself?
I know. It spoiled me, that job. But, I mean, that was also a very different show. It had an engine. You knew every episode was someone gets killed, you got to find the guy, you got to prove that they did it, and that's basically every episode.
So this show's got to be a little bit more... fun in some ways, I would assume, because it is a little bit more challenging.
Yeah.
And there are different aspects going into it and different storylines consistently happening.
Yeah.
Do you like the challenge?
Yes, I like the challenge because it's never boring. We also have an incredible writer's room. So the job is fun because some of my best friends are now in that room, and I think they're all incredibly talented. I think they bring something unique and really enlightening to the process. I learn from all of them, and so that's the best part of the job. Is, you know, you can be on a great show and the room is awful, or you can be on an awful show and the room is great. And we're on a really good show with a really great room, so it's great.
Well, I think that when you're constantly learning from each other and really collaborating with each other, it keeps it fresh.
Yeah.
And it keeps you motivated and invigorated about what you're doing, because I would assume that, you know, if you're in a room where people are not collaborating well, it could be a very challenging, especially with how long the days are. So, you're on a good room now.
I'm in a good room now, and I do think being in a writer's room is a little bit like being on a submarine, or, because I'm a nerd, I say it's, you know, the USS Enterprise. Basically, but the reason why it's like a submarine is you don't surface for 9 months. You're in that room. You're the people around that table, the people you're going to be on this tour of duty with. And if they're good people, then you're going to make it back to port safely. And if they're not, you might be thrown out the airlock, or they might be. It's better when everyone is on the same page and on the same team, and not that there are no backstabbers or snakes in the room. Because sometimes there are.
Oh, come on, on a show like Revenge.
No, I got to tell you, our show is incredibly supportive of each other. I like to say I'm the least talented guy in the room, because I really do think everyone else on the staff has amazing talent. They make my writing way better. Their notes, when I read their notes, I go like, oh, right, yeah, that's the right way to do the scene. It makes me a better writer.
I love how humble you are.
No,
genuinely, it's very nice to see that, because you're doing what so many people dream of doing. You know, you're at a level where you could easily lose that graciousness, that gratitude for the fact that you're getting to do what you love and working with the people that you work with, but you're very humble. You're very, you just seem very grateful to be where you are.
I am very grateful because I think also I came to it much later in the process. Like I had another career and I came in. The nice thing about being a drama writer especially is the later you start in your life, the probably the better you're going to be because you've done other things.
Yep.
And you're a more well-rounded person and you're not just rewriting or retelling stories that you've seen somewhere else. You're actually tapping into something real. So I'm very, very grateful to be on this show and to have this as a career, especially because I had a lot of people tell me, like, you're not going to make it. And so it kind of feels like, great, yes, I did make it. So
probably some advice would be, like, just keep fighting for it and live your life.
Yes, that's really key. Waylon Green, who was my mentor and was the showrunner at Criminal Intent, he said he doesn't like to hire people that haven't done other things, that if all they've done is be a writer, then they don't really have anything they're pulling from. Mm-hmm. So don't be afraid of the fact that you've had other careers and done other things. That only makes you a better writer. And keep working hard at it. And don't just work on one script. Don't, get to the end of one, then move to the next one. You need a drawer full of scripts because each one you're going to learn something. I've written a whole bunch of episodes of Revenge now or Law and Order, and I look back at the early Law and Order stuff that I did and I go like, wow, I would totally do that differently now. That could have been such a better story if I did A, B, or C. And I still do that on this show. I just turned in a script last night and I said, that is so much better than stuff I did in season 2 or something. And it's because of the people around me kind of forcing me to be a better writer.
They're helping build you up.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
100%.
Well, thank you so much.
Yeah.